You're welcome to my channel. My name is Beauty Akpai. How I met my husband. Okay, before I go into the video, I want you to click on the subscribe button and click on the notification bell so you get to know when I post an interesting video. So I decided to do this video to more like give you a gist on how I met my husband. Yes, I met my husband about 10 years ago. Yeah, we didn't date up to a year before we got married. So for those people that you need to study somebody like a university, yes, it's very okay to study somebody, but you don't need to study somebody for 10 years before you really know who they are. The fact is, if you like study somebody for 10 years, you would not know them. When you get married to them, new things will keep, you just have to keep seeing new things come out before your eyes or come to play. Well, that's not my story for today. I met him 10 years ago. Guess what? He was never my type. He wasn't even a monk. You know, they're a monk. He was not a monk. He was never my type, but today I feel like he's the best decision I made after Christ. After accepting Christ into my life, my husband is my greatest blessing. And I'm so glad that I wasn't carried away by looks. No, looks was among, but I wasn't carried away because I had my list. That's why I tell single ladies that no matter how much of an expectation you have, just make sure they are not unrealistic, okay? Because sometimes some of you have very long lists. You know those long ones? They are very, very long. Some of you just need to reduce some of those lists, because sometimes when he comes, he might not look like it, but he could be your greatest decision. Yes, I met my husband in 100 level in my university. He was actually a campus fellowships pastor. And when I got to school, I never even wanted to go to his fellowship. But my brother was attending the fellowship and he wanted me to come. You know, the first time I came to the fellowship, my husband is actually a pastor and he's a prophet. The day I went there, he prophesied to me that there's nothing I do, I'm going to end up in church. I was a ministry material. He said, even if I don't end up marrying a pastor, that somewhere along the line, I will end up as a pastor. I rejected it because, there's no way I'll be a pastor. So I rejected that prophecy and life moved on until a day to my matric, I had an accident and I had a major fracture on my right leg. And I was going to defer my admission, but one thing led to another. That's a story for another day. My mom said, no, you have to go to school. And at that point, I was very, very angry at my husband because I was in his choir. I was a choir member and, you know, a choir member had an accident. You didn't even come to check up on your member. He was actually angry because I didn't tell him before I traveled. I did not tell him I was traveling home because I went home and came back to school that day because it was a day to my matriculation. I went to school to get my matriculation gown. When coming back, I was run over by a bike, which left me with a fracture on my right leg. So I was angry that he didn't even come to see me. And the day he finally came, he just came with juice. You know, Five Alive. Yes, he came with juice and he prayed with me. And I shall say amen. So one of these days we're having a drama night in the fellowship. Though those days I was still struggling to walk with my leg, and a lady was sitting before me. And when my husband entered into the fellowship, all these times my husband was in a relationship, like I never knew anything was wrong in his relationship. I knew he was in a relationship. So you know when something has never crossed your mind, you never thought about it. I never thought I was going to marry him because I never wanted to marry a pastor. So when I was sitting down and he entered the fellowship, the lady sitting in front of me said something like, wow, this man is handsome. The lady was talking to her friend. She was like, I think he's the most handsome man in this fellowship. And the lady whispered to the lady and was telling him that that's their pastor. Don't come and be tripping for pastor. Focus on the drama night. And maybe I was sitting, I was like, what is handsome about him that they are even talking about? I was like, I beg you, where the fine? As usual. So I never found him that. I'm like, where to find there? Because I didn't really, he was my pastor. I respected him a lot. But you know those tripping. Yes, you know, some ladies in church used to trip. Oh, they used to trip for their pastor. I wasn't tripping. Especially, you know, those single pastors that ladies who like daddy around because maybe they want the attention or they want somebody to, you know. I wasn't among. I know they're among. Because then I was in a relationship too. But the mystery that happened between me and my husband was I was going through a breakup. He was also going through a breakup. None of us knew. It was more like we broke up with our partners at the same time. So one day after taking my bed in the lodge I was staying in the university in those days, I saw his poster. Then something told me that what if you marry this man? I laughed. I never knew it was the Holy Spirit. I looked at the poster. Somebody said, what if you marry this man? I'm like, God, Habba. He's not my type, number one. Then, this man is in a relationship. So what if you marry? So, you know, since it wasn't something that I've ever thought about before, I rejected the thoughts and it never crossed my mind again. So after having this accident, we normally go to fire night at Aochi Omega Fire Ministries every month's end. So he would hire a bus that would take members who are interested in going for that all night to go. I never went before. So I was still battling with my crutches and I was wondering who will marry a lady with one leg. When my brother came and walked up to me, he told me that he needed me to go for this all night. That he believes when Apostle Johnson Suleiman prays for me, I'll be able to walk with my leg. And I said, no, I don't want to go. So that was how he went to talk to the pastor, and my husband actually shouted at him. That increased the anger I was feeling towards him. Musgrave shouted at him that it was already late, there was no space for me, the bus was filled up, and if he had actually wanted me to go for the journey, he should have just said it before now. So my brother started begging him that I was having issues with my leg. He wanted me to go because he knows that if I go and maybe they pray for me, I'll be okay. And my husband finally agreed and he said, but on one condition, if she must go, you stand all through the journey for her to see it. My husband said, okay, no problem, because it was actually a big coaster bus. He said, no problem. So that was how I we embarked on that journey. I embarked angry because at first, why did he even refuse me going, even in my condition? So when we got there, I discovered that his behavior towards me changed. Something happened the moment I entered the bus. I never knew he had caught feelings. No, it was when we got there, I noticed his attitude changed towards me. I never knew I had a conversation with his brother. Maybe because of the way I was behaving with my brother. My brother and I are so close and we play a lot. So his brother actually thought my brother was my boyfriend or my fiancé. So he told my husband that, Kai, this girl, the way she's so close to this guy, are they lovers? My husband said, no, that's her brother. And the brother said, wow, the way she is with her brother, I think she's going to make a good wife since you are going through a breakup. And he was like, this may be true. He said that was how he started observing me. And he noticed I was so loving towards my brother. And he felt, no, I would make a good wife. I never knew. But I noticed his character actually changed. He became more loving and caring all of a sudden. So he called me upstairs inside the church building. And he wanted like talking to me as a pastor. And I was so open to him. He started asking me questions like, what's the kind of, what's your spec? What kind of man would you want to marry? And I said, he must not be a pastor. He has to be thoughtful. I hate stupid people. I gave him all my list, yeah, God-fearing, you know. But the top of my list was he must be a thoughtful person. I don't like fools. He has to be thoughtful and he has to fear God, not necessarily a pastor. So I noticed when I said thoughtful, he said, I'm thoughtful. I never knew he was advertising himself. But I noticed he was unnecessarily caring. And That evening, he walked up to me and asked me that if I knew anybody called Joy. I said, yes, Joy was my sister. I never knew he was waiting to get his confirmation. So that was where the journey began. When we got back to our base that day, he took advantage of me because he knew my qualities, the qualities I wanted. So it was more like he was putting himself in the position to be that person, though he was and he still is that person. And I noticed that he would be calling to check up on me, my leg and everything. And he wasn't concerned about the fact that I wasn't working properly then. He fell in love with what looked like my lowest, the way I was walking that time. And I was actually leaping. So I would discover he was calling me unnecessarily. And it was actually a week he opened up to me that he was having feelings for me and he would want to settle down with me. The question I asked him was, I thought you were in a relationship. What happened? He said that they are no longer together and he was actually going through a heartbreak. And at that point, I knew he was hurting. So we just started out as friends. We didn't go straight into the relationship. So just 2 months into the friendship, one month into it, he opened up to me that he wants to settle down. And that was how the journey began. So the lesson you need to learn from this is, it doesn't matter the weakness you have, or it doesn't matter how you look. One person who appreciates you for who you are, because then my leg was broken. On top of it, it was bent. I was not even walking properly because of the fracture. But what he fell in love with was my wicked point. I'm not talking about insecurities. I'm not talking about bad character. No man will accept a bad character. I'm talking about what you don't even feel good about yourself. When the one for you come, he's not going to be complaining that you are fat. He won't complain that you have bow leg. He won't complain that your head is too big. He's going to love your head for your head. So that is it. So he never complained. And from then, we didn't date up to 1 year before we got married. And I can tell you that has been my best decision ever. So it doesn't matter how you are or what is going on around your life. When the one that is for you comes, he will celebrate you. He will value you. He will love you. So that was how we started. My parents didn't accept because they felt I was in school and I was just in 100 level. My husband and I got married in 200 level. We were both in 200 level in school when we got married. You won't believe that. So we actually graduated together. We schooled together, everything. So we got married in 200 level and today we are blessed with 2 kids. It remains my best, the best decision I ever made. So that was how I met my husband. So the thing is, when the one for you come, yes. And do you know, I didn't really get the confirmation I needed until after my introduction. You know, some of you keep battling with, what's the will of God? Could this person be the will of God for me? I didn't get it. What I knew was that, I normally tell people, I say, God's will is God's word. So people are looking for big signs to fall. This person, is his character in line with what the word says? Is he God-fearing? Does he know God? Does he have somebody he respects? So for me, I was convinced because he had some of the things I wanted, not all. But one thing that convinced me was the fact that he was going somewhere, he feared God, and he was a thoughtful person. So I didn't get confirmation before I did introduction. I didn't get all the confirmation. What happened was, it was immediately after my intro, I had a dream. I saw Sunday Oguche, a man of God I respect so much. And in the dream, the man told me that, I know you are confused about marrying this person. He said, go ahead. The only thing is, it won't be easy since the both of you are in school. But I think he's a good person. Go ahead. So that was my confirmation I got. So I don't know about his own confirmation. He said when he was praying about me, he saw green grass, which means I was fruitful. And guess what? Even when I married, I didn't keep it until after 5 years. I was fruitful for him. That means I was good for him. So that is it. Some of you don't go about looking for will of God when the signs are before your eyes. If you ask God, there's nothing wrong with asking God. It's very important. I ask God. But sometimes the will of God is God's word. If he doesn't give you big signs, just make sure you have this peace. God is not an author of confusion. If you always find yourself confused or you are wondering, could this be? Pause and take your time to get your confirmations. So I hope this video has been helpful. Don't forget to leave a comment and subscribe to my channel for more interesting topics. See you next time. I remain Beauty Agbaye.